going down, taking the fall. Now I've got nothing, and I know it's my fault. Some things that are broken, they'll never mend. This is the beginning of the end.
Over 20 years of being married to Eve, I've never seen this side of her. I mean, I had no clue. Who is this woman?
The real Eve? The one she's been hiding from you all these years?
My mother never even sung a lullaby to me, Chad, but look at her. Listen to her.
Now we know where you got your singing ability from. She's amazing.
Been crying these tears.
No, Chad, she's not. She's a hypocrite and fraud, is what she is.
I'm making a river where I just might drown. Cause I'm losing everything, even my friends. This is
wonderful.
The beginning of the end.
This takes me back so many years when I first heard her sing at the Blue Note in Boston. She mesmerized me then. She still does.
Really love her, don't you?
I'm going down.
With all my heart and soul.
Taking the
fall. I made a lot of mistakes. Fox, the biggest one, was ever letting her get away.
And I know it's my fault. Some things that are broken, they'll never mend. This is the beginning of the end.
Promise me you won't leave Louise. Promise me, Sheridan.
You know, I don't want to subject Louise to the Crane curse. I don't want to take on that responsibility.
It's not you. It's Alistair.
How do you... Oh, of course, you saw that documentary on my family. So you know the terrible things that he's done.
Yes, I do. And I know that if you walk away from Louise, you are letting your father win. Oh, don't do that, Sheridan. Don't let him take away your true love, your happiness. Stay with Louise. Don't ever leave him.
Why does this mean so much to you?
Because I know that running away doesn't solve anything. You think you're trying to help somebody else or yourself from more pain, but it doesn't. Eventually, it catches up with you. And trust me, trust me when it does. The pain is so much worse.
I feel like you're talking from experience. What is it? Mrs. Wheeler, what are you running away from?
I have something on Martin Fitzgerald, a secret I doubt even Catherine is privy to. But I know it, and Martin knows I know it, and fear of me divulging that secret has kept him from contacting his family or returning to Harmony all these years.
There must be some secret, Mr. Crane.
Oh, it is, it is. Only now that Louise is down there with him, Martin's pathetic fatherly emotions may trump his fear, mistakenly lead him to tell his son the truth about who he is. And that would be Martin's biggest mistake in a life full of mistakes.
What are you so afraid of?
I remember this one time. It was when we all still lived on the Crane estate. He was building this big old gazebo, and I was helping him. But, I didn't know how to use a saw back then, and he was trying to teach me, and the saw jumped and it cut his arm. I mean, bad. You know, he needed stitches, and yeah, but he wasn't angry. You know, my father actually said that the scar was a good thing, that it reminded him of our time together and of his son.
We all have our demons, Louise. Things we run from.
Yeah, we do. Hey, look, you know, I didn't mean to pry. The thing is, you've just been so helpful to me and Sheridan ever since we got to Mexico, and I just wanted to help if I could.
You really mean that?
Yeah, absolutely.
I guess we all have to stop running one day and face our fears. Maybe my time is now.
She betrayed me.
No. But you're not alone.
This is the beginning of the end.
I know finding out about your mother's past was a shock. But maybe you try to understand.
I don't understand lying to the people that you care about, Chad. Okay? I don't understand it, and I don't forgive it.
And I know it's my fault. Some things that are broken, they'll never mend.
Look, I knew you and Dr. Russell had a past together, but all those things Liz was saying about her, the drinking and the drugs, is all that true?
Liz made it sound much worse than it actually was. All you need to know is that Eve was a good, decent person who I led astray. It caused her to lose everything she cared about back then. I caused her to lose everything all over again, but this time, I won't let her suffer alone. This time, I will do everything I can to help her. I'm gonna start by finding our son. Hopefully, now that this is all out in the open, the search will be easy and I'll be able to find him. At least that'll be one thing that won't cause Eve heartache.
This is the beginning of the end.
From something, aren't you? I am so sorry. We only just met, and I have no right to pry. It's just that I feel so connected to you. I can see so much pain in your eyes. Is this about your daughter? What? Why, I know you said that you hadn't seen your daughter in years, and how your ex-husband had kept you two apart. Is that what you're running away from?
Get back in the house. You'll catch your death.
Sheridan couldn't sleep, Alistair, so we came out to count the stars.
You're mad. Enough of this tomfoolery. Silent, Sheridan. Cranes don't cry.
Don't be so rough with her, Alistair, please.
Mommy!
I'm so sorry. No, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to push you. I didn't mean to make you relive any painful memories. It's just that I felt so connected to you ever since we met at the airport. So if there's any way that I can help.
Oh.
You know, sometimes life can be so complicated, Luis.
Yeah.
You know, it starts out simple enough. You do something, help someone in trouble. Then you suddenly realize it's all escalated and you're right in the middle of it.
There's no turning back.
Yeah. And it's not just the other person's problem anymore, it's yours too. And backing down isn't an option because it would put the other person, yourself, and a lot of people you love in danger.
So you have to make a stand.
Well, that's right. And sometimes you have to take a very drastic action. You know, sacrificing the things that you love more than anything in the world. Bringing enormous pain to the people closest to you. And the hard part is that you can't tell them what you're doing and why. You just have to act, knowing that they'll probably come to hate you.
Because they won't know the truth.
Exactly.
But they'll be safe.
You hope so.
Well, you know, it takes a strong man to make that kind of sacrifice. Is that the sacrifice that you had to make?
I caused a great deal of pain, but the alternative would have been worse. It haunts me every day of my life.
Well, look, I'm sure if the sacrifice you made helped the people that you love, they'll forgive you.
You believe that?
Yes.
I'm not sure I deserve forgiveness, Louise. But I need to ask you.
Ever after, that's the promise made. Love and laughter till the memories fade, leaving only pain like sunny days that rain. Got to wonder how it comes to be.
Maybe we should go.
No, Chad, I need to see this. I need to hear her. I've known her my whole life, but I don't know her at all.
And sunny days can rain. When love is gone.
What's Whitney doing here?
There ain't nothing.
I have no idea.
The skies are gray.
Listen, I was thinking you're going to be pretty busy with helping Dr. Eve and searching for my new half-brother.
It's my top priority.
I was just thinking, you know, I'd be willing to help you out. Covering any business that you've got going on right now. If you trust me enough.
Of course I do, but burying yourself in work isn't going to solve anything. You're still going to have to sort out your feelings for Whitney.
There's nothing for me to sort out, Dad. I love her, and I know that she's the one that has to sort out her feelings.
I told you before, I believe that she loves you, but she's not ready yet to face those feelings. Perhaps she never will be.
Well, I hope she will be. I hope it's before she marries Chad. It won't ruin my chances of ever being with her.
When love is gone.
Eve certainly didn't waste time getting back to her old life, singing in bars, carrying on with Julian.
What do you mean?
Julian's sitting right over there. Probably waiting to hand her a drink or some pills.
There ain't nothing you can do. Those sunny days
on you.
Why do you need to ask my forgiveness?
Well, because...
Oh, right. Do I believe that if someone has hurt someone they love, that they should be forgiven?
Luis.
Of course. Of course I do. I think that everyone deserves forgiveness. Everyone but my father, that is. He disappeared years ago. You know, he just left the house one day and never came back. So for years I told myself that he must be dead. You know, because there was no way that anyone from my family could cause such pain and devastation. You know, for years, my mother lit a candle in the window, praying for my father's safe return. He never came. He didn't even bother to call, nothing. Bastard.
But you said that you believe in forgiveness.
Yeah, I do. For everyone but my father. You know, he ran out on us, and as far as I'm concerned, that bastard could keep on running.
Love and laughter till the memories fade, leaving only pain like sunny days that rain. just lovers, too in love to see. Seasons always change.
And sunny days. What is my father doing here?
I don't know. Andy's with Liz.
Will you look at the paint on his face, Chad?
Gone. What is it?
Julian's here too. My poor father probably came here to try to work things out with my mother, but there she is, acting like the tramp that she always was. You know, I gotta go be with him. I gotta go make sure he's okay.
No. It might make things worse if he knows you're here at the club too.
Okay, maybe we should just go. Okay.
Hey, Fox. What are you doing here?
Liz asked me to close the place for her. What are you guys doing here?
Well, Whitney wanted to stop by, and that's before we knew it. Her mother was here.
You know, Chad, why don't we just go, okay?
Hold on, son, I gotta do something first.
What do you have to do?
I'm gonna try to talk your father into leaving before he tries to kill Julian. Fox, will you wait with Whitney outside?
I will, if it's okay with
no,
her.
No, I don't need Fox to wait with me. I'll be fine.
In this neighborhood? I'll be right back.
But
promise.
Chad, honey,
not please, I promise. All right? Watch after her.
I will. We should go this way. Just like sunny days.
Fantastic.
Oh, thank you so much.
And you obviously love singing.
Yes, I do. I'd forgotten how much.
Well, don't stop.
You didn't waste any time, did you, Eve?
How long have you been here?
I've been here long enough. How do you do it, Eve? How do you shut the door on the past 20 years, on your marriage, on your family, and then just go back to your old lifestyle so quickly? Yeah. I guess once a whore, always a whore, huh?
Watching those four on a monitor isn't enough. I need to know what they're saying. It's time to plant the bugs.
Will do, boss.
I have to be sure Catherine and Martin don't decide to tell Sheridan and Luis who they really are.
Hello? Mama! How are you feeling? Are you all right?
Oh, I'm feeling better, mijo. Much better. Are you and Sheridan in Puerto Arena yet?
Yeah, we're here. This place, it's even more beautiful than I ever imagined. Seriously, I don't know how you ever left.
Oh, God willing, I will see my homeland again soon. Have you seen your sister Paloma?
Yeah, I saw Paloma.
Ay, my sweet angel, mi angelito. I bet she's even prettier than in her pictures, huh?
Yeah, she's beautiful.
Tell me, Luis. Tell me about my sweet, innocent young angel.
Oh, my God. That is Paloma.
Luis? Mijo. Are you still there?
Yeah, Mama.
Tell me everything about Paloma.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to push you, and it seems like even my touch causes you pain.
Oh, please don't take it that way.
It's just that ever since we met, I feel like we were connected from the start.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. I suppose maybe it's because you and your husband have been so wonderful to Paloma all these years. You're so welcoming to Luis and me. Treated us like family.
Because you are my family.
What?
Fox, you can go back inside. I don't need you to wait out here with me.
No, it's okay. Chad asked me to.
Chad thinks he can trust you, Fox. But we both know he can't.
You know that's not true.
Well, it is true because you're constantly putting the moves on his fiance behind his back, right? I mean, he thinks that you're so in love with your mystery woman that you can't even think about anyone else. But what Chad doesn't know is that I am your mystery
woman.
Look,
Whitney, listen.
No, Fox, I can't deal with this right now, okay? Not after everything that's gone on tonight. I can't deal with any of this. Not you. Not my mother, not your father, not my whole messed up life.
Well, hold on a second, though. Your life isn't the only one that got messed up tonight, Whitney. I just found out that I have a new half-brother.
So you didn't know anything about that before?
No, I knew nothing about that before. Up until now, I thought Ethan was my only half-brother.
And I thought Simone was my only sibling, too.
Well, there you have it. Life's just full of little surprises, isn't it?
Yeah. And none of them good, right? I mean, it was bad enough when I thought Mom and your father were having an affair, but then we find out that they had this whole life together years ago, and that she was a singer. I mean, that just blows my mind because she went so crazy because I wanted a singing career, you know? I mean, what did she think, that I was gonna end up like her? Some kind of drunk or drug addict or something?
Whitney, come on, I think she's just trying to protect you.
That's not the point, Fox. She lied to us. To her whole family, to my father. I mean, my God, the idea that she had a baby with Julian Crane? The man that my father hates most in the world? I mean, that kills my father.
Yeah, I know.
Your father and my mother had a child together. I mean, think about it, Fox. Somewhere in harmony, you and I share a half-brother.
Yep.
Now every 20-something guy I see, I'm gonna wonder, is that him, you know? Is that my brother?
You truly disgust me.
That is rich coming from the man who turned Eve into a drug addict and a whore.
You know, I should wring your neck for what you did tonight. Eve may have made some mistakes in her life, but she never once hurt anyone intentionally. She never deliberately lied to cause people heartache. She never set out to destroy people's lives the way you did.
Eve destroyed lives, Julia, mine included.
She did not destroy your life. Your father abused you, and that's unforgivable. But blame him, not her.
She abandoned me to him.
She didn't know anything about what was going on.
Yes, right. Because she was out drinking and whoring around.
Eve has done things she's not proud of. But compared to the evil, bitter bitch you are, she's a saint. And one day, TC will discover that.
Seems like old times, doesn't it, Eve? You're back singing in nightclubs. Your rich boyfriend is nearby. All you need now is to get you some drugs. Oh, I forgot. You can write your own prescriptions now, huh?
TC, please stop it.
Eve, how did you pay for your drugs back then? It's pretty obvious that you didn't make any money singing. But I know that Julian was paying for your services. Did you sell your body to your drug dealers, too?
Stop it. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that.
Yes, you did. Because this is who you are, Eve. And I wished I would have found out about you a long time ago. I can't believe that I wasted my whole life with a tramp like you.
I'm your family?
I meant that you're like my family. Because of Paloma. I mean, as you know, we've been like her godparents all these years, and we think of her as family, which means that you and Luis are family, too.
Right. You have been so helpful and wonderful ever since we arrived. And you have such an amazing relationship with Paloma. I think of you as family, too. I guess that's why I called you mother earlier. But still, there's just something so familiar about you. I'm sorry. Just whenever I think about my mother, I miss her so much. Sometimes I wonder what my life would have been like if she hadn't died. Sometimes I tell myself that she didn't. That she's really still alive.
Do you really think that?
No. No, I don't. I know it's impossible. Besides, that would mean that she deserted me. Left me to live a life of hell with my father. I know she wouldn't do that. She never would have done that. She loved me. She would have never done something so cruel and selfish.
Tell you about Paloma.
Yes, and don't leave anything out.
Well, like I said, she's beautiful, and she's doing well in school, and she seems to be very popular.
Well, good. And church? Is she a good Catholic girl, attending Mass every Sunday?
Every morning.
Every morning? That's wonderful. Have you seen a nice couple who's looked after Paloma?
The Wheelers. Yeah, I've met them. They're very nice, and they're wonderful to Paloma and Tia Maria. In fact, I was just talking to Mr. Wheeler right now. He's right here.
Oh, well, good. I'd love to say hello to him and to thank him.
Well, I'm sure he'd love to talk to you, too. Just hold on a second, okay?
My father's committed to finding their lost son, so I'm sure eventually we're gonna know who he is.
Yeah, this whole situation is such a mess, you know? My mother's lies have destroyed everything. My whole family has fallen apart. My parents' marriage is over. My father's ready to kill, and Simone's still mad at me because she thinks I stole Chad from her. God, I feel like my whole life is falling apart around me.
It's a tough time for you. Whitney, listen, if I can be of any help at all, and I mean strictly as friends, then you just...
No, there's no way. I can't be friends with anyone I can't trust.
You still can.
Not after you lied to me.
I didn't lie to you.
Yeah, you did.
No, I didn't.
No, Fox, you did. Every time you touched me, you lied to me. Every time you held me. Every time we were together, you know, when we slept in the same bed together? You led me to believe that that was all out of friendship, but it wasn't. You had an ulterior motive the whole time.
Whitney, I never had an ulterior motive. Ever. And I've told you, I do have feelings for you that go way beyond friendship, and I never acted on them. I never made a move on you. And I always respected you.
If you really respected me, you never would have lied to me to begin with.
I don't know. I don't know why it's so... I don't know why it's such a bad thing. Why is it a bad thing for me to tell you that I'm in love with you?
Because, okay? I'm hurting right now, okay? It's not supposed to hurt. Love isn't supposed to hurt, and this hurts. I'm hurting. I'm torn. I don't...
What did you say? Why would you say you were torn and hurting unless... Are you in love with me?
Mr. Wheeler? Mama? Hey, he must have stepped away.
Oh, that's okay, mijo. I'll talk to him another time. What about you? When are you all coming home? When do I see my Paloma?
Well, I'll let you know as soon as I know my plans, okay?
Oh, good. I hope to be out of this hospital by then. I have to prepare this big dinner for everyone.
Well, you just rest and listen to your doctors, you hear me?
I know. I will, I promise.
I love you.
I love you too, mijo. And Luis, thank you, mijo. Thank you for bringing Paloma home and bringing our family back together. Maybe it's a sign. Maybe now your father will come home to us.
Good night, Mama.
Hey. How about a cold beer?
Thanks. Sorry you missed my mother. She, just wanted to thank you for everything you've done.
Jeez, you know. Yeah, but I heard what you told her about your sister.
Yeah. I mean, I hated lying to her, but there was just no way that I could tell the truth, not with the condition that she's in now. You know? It's bad enough that Paloma is out there dancing on tables. Now, if she knew that she was angry because she felt like we abandoned her, there's just no way it would kill her.
Yeah.
You know what else she said? She thinks that maybe Paloma's coming home is a sign that my father's gonna come home too.
She still thinks he's going to come home?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. No, she never gave up hope on that bastard. You know, stayed true to him. But let me tell you something, there were a lot of other men who were interested. Good, honorable men. But no, she had to stay true to my father.
Couldn't she have declared him dead?
My mother? Oh, no. No. Her wedding vows were sacred. You know, not unless there's proof that my father is dead. And she's not gonna move on. She'll remain faithful, which I'll bet you is more than I can say for my father. You know something? My mother may not have lost faith in my father, but I'll tell you something. I sure as hell have.
Please.
Hey.
I thought you were still asleep.
I was. And, well, then I woke up. I was just talking to Mr. Wheeler.
Are you all right?
Yeah, it couldn't be better. I was just... got us a couple of beers. Would you ladies care to join us?
Oh, thank you, but it's been a long night. I think I'm gonna head to bed.
Yeah, you know what? Me too.
Oh, good night. Good night.
Good night.
Buenas noches. More painful than I ever imagined.
I know.
Bugs are all planted and ready to start transmitting, Mr. Crane.
Good.
You should hear some pretty good stuff, boss. Catherine and Martin look pretty upset.
The more pain they're in, the better. I want them to suffer before I kill them, and I want to watch it. When my wife ran away with that peon all those years ago, she thought there'd be no consequences. But nobody leaves Alistair Crane. I've waited a long time for this. And now I'm going to teach Catherine and Martin a lesson they'll never forget. I'll make them regret ever thinking they could escape my wrath.
I don't want to push you. But I'm in love with you. I love you more than I've ever loved anything in my entire life. And I really gotta know how you feel about me. You say that you're torn. What does that mean? Does that mean you feel the same way about me? Sense something from you for a long time now, little signs, and I don't know if they're real or if they're wishful thinking, and I want to know if they're real.
Father was, busy.
Oh, well, that's okay.
It's getting late. Thanks for keeping an eye on her.
Yeah.
Box, no problem. We should go.
Okay.
And we'll see you tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow it is.
Just wait, Liz. You'll get yours.
Are you threatening me, Joe?
What goes around comes around.
Oh, I agree. All the terrible things that Eve put me through, all the hell that my life has been because of her, it is finally coming around. And it's her time to suffer.
She's suffered enough already. She didn't need this.
Oh, Julian, if you think Eve is suffering now, wait till you get a load of what I have in store for her.
The Wheelers are so dear. I just feel this profound sadness from them.
Right? I sense that too. Like, I don't know, something caused them both a lot of pain. And it seemed like Mr. Wheeler was about to confide in me, but then he shut down.
Yeah, Mrs. Wheeler was telling me that her first marriage wasn't good, and she was separated from her daughter. I still sense that there's something more, though.
Well, you know, maybe just give him a little more time. They'll feel more comfortable with us. Open up.
I hope so. You know, I want to be there for them, especially Mrs. Wheeler. I don't know, in a strange way, I just feel connected to whatever pain she's feeling.
You know, Sharon told me that sometimes she fantasizes that her mother is still alive. But then she told me it couldn't be true because her mother never would have deserted her like that and left her to a life of hell with Alistair. Oh, Mark, when she finds out who I am, she's going to hate me.
Luis already hates me for abandoning my family. He said if he ever saw his father again, he'd kill him for what he put Pilar through.
Oh, what are we gonna do?
We're gonna get ready for the truth to come out. And a lot more pain.
You have no idea how much, Martin. You can't even imagine what I've planned for you.
Staying here tonight because I've destroyed my family.
Oh, could this night get any better?
I just need to leave Harmony forever and just never look back.
I'm never gonna let anyone or anything come between us again.
Next Friday, America.
In the world. The Summer Olympics start next Friday on the networks of NBC.